Hi student, this is Praveen Choudhary, Assistant Professor, Faculty of Hotel and Tourism Management, SGT University, Gurgaon, Haryana. Today we learn about gin. So in gin, we cover these topics. First is the origin of gin. So in origin of gin, we learn from which place and who is made first gin. The second, we learn the types of gin. So different type of gin we learn. And then third is manufacturing, that different types of gin, how we'll manufacture. Then some international and Indian brand names we learn. And in last, we learn some famous cocktail made from gin. So first we'll start, what is the gin? So here, like in slide you see, gin is a distilled spirit made from fermented malted barley, corn, rye. Or gin is colorless drink. We are adding in that juniper flavor. If we are not adding juniper flavor in that, it becomes vodka. So other flavor also you can add with the juniper berries like coriander seeds, cardamom, fennel, etc. So the gin we mature in glass lined container or stainless steel cask. We can't mature the gin in wood cask because it's get color from wood. So now we come the history of gin. First of all, we see the juniper berries. This fruit we use for giving flavor to our gin. So now the word gin comes from a French word ginevra. It means juniper berries that we are using in our gin. So some people believe that Dr. Silivus, he is a physician and professor of medicine from Holland in Leiden University. He made first gin. People think he is a person who made a first gin because he is very familiar with the properties of juniper oil. So the juniper oil is very beneficial for the healing of kidney. So the juniper berries, it is very helpful also for medicine purpose, but nowadays people are enjoying the gin as a alcohol drink also. So now we come in the types of gin. So that there are different type of gin, like we have seen Holland gin. Holland gin, another name is Dutch gin. Holland gin is a full bodied gin in that we are using equal quantity of malted barley, rye, corn, and we'll after fermentation we'll do the distillation. In this Holland gin will do the distillation 2 times in pot still method. Then we come London dry gin. London dry gin, another name is dry gin. So London dry gin, the term adopted by American and other countries also. It is little bit different from the Holland gin. The manufacturing process is little bit different. In that we are using, first we are using patent still method and second we are using pot still method. In that we are not using malted barley. In that we are using 75% of barley, 15% of corn, 10% of rye and other grains. So the third is Boots gin. It is similar to the London dry gin, but it have a special color. Boots gin we matured in wood cask for giving golden color. So all Boots gins are in golden color. Now we come on the manufacturing process of Dutch gin and London dry gin. Now we learn the manufacturing process of different type of gin. First we start the Dutch gin. The another name of Dutch gin is Holland gin. We'll take alcoholic wash made by fermented cereals, and now we'll do the distillation process. Distillation process will do in the pot still method. The first distillation completed will come in second distillation. In second distillation also we use same pot still method. At second distillation we add juniper berries for giving flavor to our gin. And we can add here in this stage, you can add other flavorings also. For example, coriander seeds, cardamom, fennel, etc. After then, we'll store our gin in glass lined container or stainless steel container. The purpose of maturing our gin here is not giving the color to our gin, giving flavor to our gin. So the maturation process in this stage will do for a little bit or little time period, not for 6 months or for 1 year, okay. Before bottling, what we'll do, we'll just dilute the spirit that we have got by the process of distillations. We'll reduce that spirit by at the temperature of 94 degree to 98 degree proof. Then we'll do the bottling. So now we can get the Dutch gin. So this is how we can make Dutch gin. Now we'll come the second process, London dry gin. So the manufacturing process is little bit different from Holland gin. In Holland gin, what we are doing, guys, we are taking malted barley. But here in this gin, we are taking only barley, not the malted one. So this gin is little bit different from the Dutch gin. Process first will start alcoholic wash made from fermented cereals. We'll use pot still method. In Dutch gin, we are using pot still method in both distillation process. Here we are using in first distillation process, we are using pot still method, and second we are using pot still method for distillation. So first we'll do the distillation in pot still method. The second distillation we are doing in the pot still method. At this stage we are adding juniper berries for giving flavor, or other botanicals you can use in this stage. After then we are mature our gin in glass lined container or stainless steel container. Before bottling, same, we reduce or we dilute our gin by adding water. The temperature of 88 degree proof to 94 degree proof. So now we'll get, or we can make or manufacture our London dry gin. Dear student, now we learn international or Indian brands of gin. This is also we should know, we should have a knowledge about that, how many types of or how many international brands, famous international brands name or the gin are available in the market. So we'll start some example of London dry gin. The first is Booth gin, Seagram gin, House of Lord, then Tanqueray, Gilbey, and then we have Beefeater or Culver. These are the famous brands of London dry gin. Now some famous brand names of Dutch gin is Cooper, then we have Don Quijote, then we have Bols. Some Indian famous brands, we should know the availability gin brands in the India or Indian hospitality industry. So these are some famous brands like Forbes, Blue Ribbon, then we have McDowell's, Aristocrat. But after coming on next slide, I want to tell you one thing, the Dutch gin we are not using for making cocktails, because in that gin have a malted flavor. As earlier we have discussed, we are using malted barley for making Dutch gin, but here in cocktail we are not taking that gin. Now dear student, we learn some famous cocktail made from gin. So we'll start with first Brimble, the second is Gimlet, third is Classic Martini. Classic Martini is very famous cocktail in international level, or in India also it's very famous. Then we have Negroni, and then we have French 75, and in last we have Sloe Gin Fizz. Sloe Gin is a brand of gin, and all Sloe Gin Fizz made from Sloe Gin only. So this is all about cocktail. Today we have completed. We have covered the what is the gin, origin of gin, and different types of gin, and the manufacturing process, what all the manufacturing process of different types of gins, and the international and Indian brand names of famous gin. And in last we have covered famous cocktail made from gin. So this is all about from my side. Thank you, dear students.